this is a small thing, but most people don't understand why you need to do it. But we will talk about it soon. Let's see. You need to have notes. The notes that I normally write down here, I'll explain in the video. So, and I think this was 24, right? And I think we wrote down a subject. Okay. Let's talk about this for a little bit. Let's say you order something online. So this is you. Let's do it here. This is you. You order something online on the internet. So on the internet, you order something online. And when you order something online, you pay for it. And you get an order confirmation back. An order confirmation is like an email. Like, hey, you ordered this and you pay for this. We will send you your product as soon as possible, or we will provide a service as soon as possible. All right? This is an order confirmation. But if you're, let's say you're working in the big companies, order companies, so let's say this is you again. You have your own company and you order, let's say, 150,000 chairs, yeah, or 150,000 wine, doesn't matter, you order a lot, right? So you order from company X products. Oh, you cannot see that. So you order from company, yeah, here you can see it. You order from company X products, yeah. And you, give me a second, yeah, you order products and then company X needs to send you products, right? But company X needs to send you an order confirmation. An order confirmation is, okay, hey, you ordered this much products, you paid this much, we sent you an order confirmation. Yeah, if I'm the boss of the company, I need to send you the order confirmation. Yeah, but you can also send order confirmation in an email, really short. You don't have to send the whole package, but can you keep it really short? Yeah, but let's say you have something simple, you can also say you can send a confirmation. Let's say I make certain kind of appointment with someone. I can send an email and ask the person, can you confirm this? Because when they confirm this, you have an agreement, an arrangement. So you see here, you have different kind of order confirmation. You can have one online, you can have offline. You can also have something that someone said, you send them an email, they confirm that, bam. But you're asking yourself, what kind of email do I send? That's what we're going to discuss right now. So, how does it start? You can start by saying confirmation of verbal order. And what you also can do is you can put it all in capital. So confirmation of verbal order to get attention. You can do it like this, but it is not necessary. Yeah, keep that in mind. Okay, if you look at this, how should we start? It can be like dear and then name. So the person that you want a confirmation of, as soon as you get the confirmation, that means they confirm what you just said. And most time it will lead to an agreement. In some of my videos, I'll explain to you why you need to ask for confirmation. And here you see how you do it. So here, there should be both. Yeah. And here, I'm going to talk about what you can write. You can write everything down, but just what you remember. Hey, can you confirm this? This appointment 1, 2, 3, 4. That's simple, and they'll be like, I can confirm it. I do this a lot when I talk with people. The reason I'm doing this is because then they'll be like, oh, I confirmed this, I talk about this, so we have proof that I said this. So let's see, how should you? This is an example. You can do it however you want, as long as you confirm the appointments. So this letter shall, you can, it's better to say this email. This email shall, because I don't like letter, shall confirm your acceptance of verbal order communicated to you on, and this is important, the date. Yeah. Thing is, if you communicate with someone on WhatsApp or Telegram, you have technically proof. But most people don't save the proof, but ask for confirmation and make a screenshot of it. It's that simple. A copy of your purchase. So let's say you order in a company. Order containing the state terms is attached. So they send you an order confirmation with your order and the state terms. Yeah, the terms, because when you accept the terms, you also accept the terms of condition. Keep that in mind. Yeah, and what you also can put is, you can put like, hey, if you don't agree with this, then you can reject it. And how do you do that? You can make an objection. So unless we receive objection, that's the better word, within 10 days or 7 days, doesn't matter, of your receipt of this order, we shall expect delivery of all order goods on the date indicated. So let's copy this and then I'll explain how you guys can use this. What I mean copy is, let's copy the last part. Okay, let's go back. Okay, yeah, this is how you can end. The date, we need to highlight it. I'm going to explain to you how you guys can use this. Like I said, if someone order a lot of things, you can use this. But you can also use this on the internet. For example, you need to change it then. For example, if you have a web shop, you can use this as like, okay, you can, this is your order, confirm it, and then I will deliver. Or if they pay, they already deliver, but it all depends what's in your terms. That's why I put terms in here. I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief. Know what I want, so I'll take it on. I've made mistakes, but mistakes make you strong. Let's break it down for a minute. I want the crown, I'm gon' get it. You hear me loud, man, I'm winning. Yeah, Charlie Sheen will be